WP Rocket is designed to make your site load faster, so let's see how you can measure the improvement. Testing your WordPress site's speed and performance might seem daunting at first, but if you have all the tools at your disposal, it really shouldn't be. In this video, we'll use Google's very own speed testing tool, Google PageSpeed Insights, which measures the performance of a page for mobile and desktop devices. Here are some best practices to keep in mind when running speed tests. First, be sure you're testing the correct version of your URL. If your site uses HTTPS, but someone types in the HTTP version of your URL, they'll still end up on your page by way of a redirect. But if HTTPS is the ultimate destination, that's what you want to use in your speed test. Otherwise, it will add unnecessary load time. Next, make sure you always run a few tests at a time to get an average result. There are a number of factors that can affect your tests, and so you don't want one anomaly to mislead you about how things are really going. Run multiple tests to get a couple of different readings, which will provide a much more accurate average to use as your final result. Third point, make sure your website caching is turned on. This means that you can test how effective caching is in improving your website performance. WP Rocket is a great plugin for this exact purpose, as it can immediately and proactively look after all your caching without you having to worry about any of the technical stuff. Remember to test from a mobile perspective. In today's modern world, the majority of your traffic is going to come from mobile devices, so it's important that you test the performance with that in mind. For example, PageSpeed Insights has a mobile and desktop part of their test, so be sure to consider both. If your site runs well on desktop, but not on mobile, you're actually missing out on a lot. One last point is about server location. Google PageSpeed Insights will calculate your score using different servers based on your physical location, which is presumably the closest or most optimal server. But if you want to choose your own location, we recommend setting up a free account on GT Metrics so you can choose different locations. The PageSpeed report itself gives you a lot of information, so here are a few key things to pay attention to. The overall score ranges from 0 to 100 points and is based on Lighthouse. A higher score is better, and a score of 90 or above indicates that the page is performing well. PageSpeed Insights looks at the overall user experience across devices and provides suggestions about how that page can be improved on both mobile and desktop. However, user experience is not the same as loading time. This means that you can have a good PageSpeed score without a fast website. And similarly, you could have a fast website, but a poor user experience and thus a bad PageSpeed score. To quickly compare the speed and performance with and without WP Rocket, you can run a test that bypasses WP Rocket by simply adding ? No WP Rocket to the URL. The report page is really useful, as you can see exactly what's contributing to a poorly performing site and how to improve your website speed. It collects data in a controlled environment, the lab data, as well as a real-world field environment, the field data. So you have full visibility on your core vitals, and you can prevent any potential problems from affecting online performance and SEO. The report gives you a useful breakdown of the steps you can take to improve performance. The interpretation of the results is pretty straightforward too. Let's dig into the main loading metrics to look at. The first contentful paint, or FCP, marks the first point when a user can see anything on the screen, and it is considered the perceived load speed. Here you're looking for it to be as small as possible, because the faster the load time, obviously, the better. So your FCP score should be less than or equal to 1.8 seconds. Next, the largest contentful paint is a core vital metric that measures how long it takes for the largest visible element on the site to be rendered. This is similar to the load time, and you want it to be as low as possible. So your LCP score should be less than or equal to 2.5 seconds. The cumulative layout shift measures how visually stable a page is by quantifying how often users might experience unexpected shifts to the layout. Ideally, your site should have a CLS score of 0.1 seconds or less. The first input delay, or FID, is the time from when a user first clicks on something to the time when the browser actually starts to process that interaction. The lower this number, the better, because it tracks how responsive a site is to the first interaction, which is a key point of the customer journey that sets expectations. If it's too high, then a visitor is likely to click away. So a good FID score should be under 100 milliseconds. The time to interactive is the amount of time it takes for the page to become fully interactive. And what makes a page fully interactive? It's when a page responds to user interactions, like a click on a button, for example, within 50 milliseconds. Underneath the metrics and results breakdown, you'll see a number of recommendations for how you can optimize potential weak points, and you can use that to chart how you're going to improve things. All right, now you should have a better idea of the performance of your site, how you can improve it, and you can start finding the best settings with WP Rocket.